Welcome back to the channel. In this video, I have some MMA news. So it has been reported that current light heavyweight champion and heavyweight champion Daniel Cormier will be stripped of his light heavyweight titles so that Jon Jones can face Alexander Gustafsson in a rematch and they'll fight for the vacant light heavyweight title. And at first, it was supposed to be Jon Jones coming back and he'll would face Daniel Cormier for the heavyweight title, but I think Daniel Cormier's team and Daniel Cormier was like, I'm not going to give Jon Jones this opportunity to win a belt in another weight class and say, I would rather fight Jon Jones at light heavyweight. So that fight, that pretty much how the negotiations went. But then, like, it was issues with the timing of the event and the weight class and this and all this other stuff on both sides of the thing. So the fight pretty much wasn't been able to be made for the end of this year. So then I think they're probably going to push it back later, but they say, let's just change the direction and have Jon Jones face Alexander Gustafsson at UFC 232, December 29th, like pretty much the final card of the year. So it kind of changed the direction. But as far as like them fighting for a vacant title or stripping Daniel Cormier, I don't really think it's the right move. I think Daniel Cormier has fought twice this year already. He defended his belt like pretty much at the beginning of this year. Then he fought at the middle part of this year and defeated Stipe Miocic, the pretty much one of the greatest heavyweights of all time in MMA. Finished him in the first round and won the heavyweight title. So he's been very active and pretty much one of his, what is his best year in MMA ever in his career. So he already fought twice this year. It's not like he's been inactive like Gustafsson. I think Gustafsson hasn't fought in like a year, maybe more, because he fought Glover Teixeira, and Glover Teixeira has at least fought twice already since they last fought. So that shows you that Alexander Gustafsson has been really inactive. So like, he doesn't really deserve a title shot due to inactivity. And Jon Jones has been testing positive for stuff and been having all these issues outside the cage and with drug use and all this stuff. So he doesn't deserve a title shot either. Like, well, I'll say an interim title shot, definitely, but it's not like you have to give him one. I think an interim is the best option in my opinion. Like, so whoever wins that fight can fight Daniel Cormier for the real title if he sticks around. If Daniel Cormier retired, because he's retiring in March. I say he's already had an active year, a very stellar year already. And he's retiring in March, so he says. And that's only, 5 months away? So it's not that much time to be saying, oh, he's been inactive for over a year or doing this or a year and a half. He's really only, he defended the title, 6 months ago or less. It's probably, 6 months ago. So he's been active enough compared to other champions and compared to the standard. And if he's retiring in March, I think it's just best to let him keep the title and let Jon Jones and Gustafsson fight for an interim title. Like I said, if he decides to retire and without defending that title, then you could just bump it up to a official title like they do with a lot of interim titles. I think it makes best sense to keep Daniel Cormier the champ. I think it looks better on paper to market him as that, especially if he still is pretty much ineligible to defend it. It's not like he's like super injured or have contract issues or anything like that. He's more than like in position enough to defend his title, both of his titles right now. And it hasn't been like past that deadline where like he's been, like I said, he hasn't been inactive. And neither Gustafsson or Jon Jones deserves it. Like, necessarily deserves a vacant title right now. Got to make them earn it. Inactivity and PED use. And like I said, you got Daniel Cormier versus Brock Lesnar. It makes the fight even more sellable when you market Daniel Cormier as a champ. Like, the first ever, you can make history right there. Like, if Daniel Cormier versus Brock Lesnar, you got the heavyweight and light heavyweight champion versus Brock Lesnar. You got Brock Lesnar. You got the champ. If Daniel Cormier wins, then he's the first ever pretty much champ to win, and not only win, but defend one of his titles. Then he could probably go down maybe in March or whenever he decides to fight. I don't know how it's going to play out, but if he has one more time for one more fight in his career, he could fight the winner of Alexander Gustafsson versus Jon Jones or Jon Jones versus Alexander Gustafsson and defend his light heavyweight title. And that'd be his last fight of his career and he could retire. Potentially going on to fight Jon Jones, maybe win, maybe Gustafsson wins. He could fight Gustafsson and he beats one of his kind of career MMA rivals and retire on that, or at least get a chance to fight one of them to end off his career. And maybe he'd be the first champion to defend both of his titles like that. But it all just sounds better if he keeps both titles. It just makes things more interesting. It's a better marketing point than if you take away one of his belts. Then he's just like a one division champion. Like, you could market him so well, like never before any champion, like crazy type of marketing when you got a champ. It's like, it's not like something that happens all the time, especially in the biggest organization in MMA. So it's like, you got to hold on to it while you can, especially if he hasn't done anything or has been inactive to the point where you had to take away the title. And like, Jon Jones versus Gustafsson is going to sell regardless. It doesn't need to be an official title on the line. It just be an interim title. And that we all know that's going to have significant way because it's John Jones. Like, he's the uncrowned king. He was the king. He never lost it. And Daniel Cormier's retiring soon anyway. So the belt's pretty much anybody that has knows anything or even knows a hint of anything already going to recognize John Jones as official champion when he wins it. Matter of fact, people already recognize him as official champion now, even without a belt. So there's no need to just give him a full title. Just give him an interim title or put an interim title on the line. Whoever wins it, and they'll be like pretty much technically the champ. And then, like, what, less than 5 months? Really, by the time of that event, be like, what, less than 2 or 3 months? If Dan Cormier does retire in March, then they'll be boosted up to the official champion. So, like, same thing, but it gives the opportunity to keep that same marketing point with Daniel Cormier, in my opinion. And that's about all I got to say. You kind of understand where I'm going with this. So, thanks for watching. Like, comment, and subscribe, and come back for more videos. Peace.